Good morning. It is 7:20 and I pretty much just woke up, and I figured since today's my last day of school and I've been kind of wanting to grow this YouTube channel over the summer and figure it out a little bit more, that I would film my first official video today, which is what I eat in a day with celiac disease.
Shining at the end of every day, there's a great big beautiful tomorrow.
So, for those of you that don't know, celiac disease is an autoimmune disease where you can't have any form of gluten. It primarily affects your small intestine. There's no cure. The only treatment is eating 100% gluten-free. If you guys are still confused, I'll link an article I wrote about celiac disease and how it affects me in the description. So, this is what I eat in a day with celiac disease. So, I follow a 100% strict gluten-free diet. I haven't had any gluten in 10 years since I was diagnosed with celiac disease, which actually isn't as hard as it can sound. There's a lot of great gluten-free options and alternatives, and I'm just gonna explain them all to you in this video, and hopefully you will learn something new about gluten-free food and the different gluten-free food options that I have every day. I am actually making apple cinnamon oatmeal for breakfast. You can hear it cooking in there. We're redoing our kitchen, so we have an induction burner. But I just thought I'd show you guys. My mom picked up some lychees from Whole Foods, and I have been obsessed with lychees for years. They're one of my favorite fruits. Look at them. They look so cool. But my blog name is Lychee and Lavender. If you guys didn't know, this is what a lychee looks like. So the first thing I'm eating today are just a couple of these because they are delicious. So right now I'm sitting on the couch and I'm actually gonna watch some Dance Moms while I eat breakfast. I've been really into Dance Moms lately. I'm watching season 3 right now. I like find it really entertaining actually, but for breakfast, I made these cinnamon and apple oats topped with walnuts, and they have a little bit of apple in them. So basically, oats are known to have gluten in them. When people are like, "Oh, what's gluten?" I say like, "It's in wheat, rye, oats, malt, and barley." But the truth is, it's actually sometimes in oats, and the breakfast I'm eating is still 100% gluten-free because I am using certified gluten-free oats. So the reason why oats sometimes have gluten is because they are often manufactured with wheat and they're grown in the same fields. So there's no way to eliminate cross-contamination between the wheat and the oats. And so a lot of the times it's just considered that most oats have gluten. And if you don't have specifically certified gluten-free oats, then they probably have been cross-contaminated with wheat at some point. The oats that I buy and I trust with celiac disease are the Trader Joe's certified gluten-free rolled oats. I have actually never had a reaction to these, but I have had a mild reaction to Bob's Red Mill. I eat just these Trader Joe's rolled oats whenever I have oatmeal. But yeah. Basically, in my oatmeal today, it is just some apples and oats and water cooked together with some cinnamon, and then I topped it with apples, walnuts, and a little bit of maple syrup. So that is my healthy gluten-free breakfast for today. And then with my breakfast, I'm also having some cinnamon cardamom tea. You do have to be careful buying teas with celiac disease or if you're gluten-free because it actually can be a hidden ingredient. All of the teas that we buy obviously are gluten-free, and most teas you'll find are 100% gluten-free. But one brand that I really like because they are certified gluten-free is Republic of Teas. They are the ones that come in those cylinders and the tea bags are round. So this is the cinnamon cardamom tea. I love it. But yeah, so if you guys are interested in some teas that are naturally gluten-free or you can find that are easily identifiable as gluten-free teas, I will put some links down below to my favorite teas. I drink tea so frequently, and it's just good to know for if you're looking for a gluten-free tea, here are some easy and reliable options. Oh, I'm currently walking around in downtown Westport with my dog, and we are trying the new acai bowl place downtown called GGN Joe's. And I haven't looked into their granola yet. I don't know if that's gluten-free, but most of their smoothie bowl bases, or actually all of their smoothie bowl bases are. I haven't really looked into if they have gluten-free bread for the avocado toast or anything like that. But I know that I am okay with the smoothie bowls and they're good about cross-contamination.
So I got a blue spirulina bowl for lunch that I'm going to eat later because it's only like 10 a.m. and a turmeric latte. So we'll see how that tastes, how that looks, and yeah.
So we just got our food from Gigi and Joe's, and I got this iced turmeric latte. I got it with almond milk, and I'm going to try it. It's actually very good. It's pretty sweet and creamy, but it really tastes like turmeric, so I would give it a 10 out of 10.
So I'm eating lunch in my room today because I'm working on some YouTube intro stuff, but I'm having this blue spirulina bowl from Gigi and Joe's where I was earlier. So I got the tropical bowl with the blue base and no granola. It is around 3 p.m. now, and I did not film it because there are people demoing our kitchen, so it was really loud downstairs, but I'll attach a picture of the homemade fudge I made yesterday, and so I just had a few pieces of that. It is really good. The recipe is really easy. It should be up on my blog soon, actually, so keep an eye out for that. But I did not film it because it was really loud downstairs in our makeshift kitchen for now, and so, yeah, that's it, but I just had a few pieces of fudge. So me and my sister are in my car now, and we are going to drive to Chipotle to pick up dinner for our family. Me and my sister just got back from Chipotle. We picked up dinner for our family, and the food is in the back, and so that is what I will be having for dinner.
This is my dinner. I got a Chipotle bowl, which Chipotle is very good about gluten-free. The only things there that you want to avoid are the tortillas, and the chips are actually in a dedicated, or in a fryer with no other gluten in it. So I got a Chipotle bowl with brown rice, beef barbacoa, black beans, some sour cream, corn, tomatoes and stuff like that. And then at home, I just put it on top of lettuce to make it more of a salad and a little bit healthier. So I have the other half of my bowl in the fridge right now, and then I just put some hot sauce on it, and that's that.
We also got chips and guac, which I am happy to say are celiac safe, so I'll also be enjoying some of those. Okay, I'm standing in our little makeshift kitchen because we're currently redoing our entire kitchen, and I am completely ready for bed except for brushing my teeth, and I'm just having a little bit of dessert to, I guess, finish my day of eating. I am having some glutino sandwich cookies, and then I am having some more cinnamon cardamom tea, which is my absolute favorite. So I am about to go to bed, but I hope you loved this video. This was a full day of eating with celiac disease. So most of the stuff that I ate today, and actually most of the stuff that I eat every day, is naturally gluten-free because I eat a lot of fruits, vegetables, like plain proteins, like grilled chicken and stuff like that. That being said, I did have oatmeal today, which you really have to be careful about if you're trying to eat gluten-free. I can link some articles down below if you guys are interested about gluten in oats, because it is a way more complicated subject than I explained. And if you are serious about your gluten intolerance, or you have celiac disease and you're genuinely looking for information, I think that you should read something from a more reputable source. However, I do have celiac disease, and the Trader Joe's oats are what work for me personally, but I do know that it is different for absolutely everyone. I also had those cookies, and those are a gluten-free alternative to Oreos. And so, yeah, that was my full day of eating with celiac disease. And I hope you guys learned something. I hope you guys realize that gluten-free food is not just rice and plain chicken. It is so, so much more than that. And if you're looking for good gluten-free recipes, I am linking my food blog down below, so please check that out. I'm working so hard to pump out recipes and lifestyle articles for you guys, and I will see you in the next video / article. Bye! There's a great big beautiful tomorrow, shining at the end of every day. There's a